And he babbles with wit and good humor. He's so quaint and so terse, both in prose and in verse, yet though people forgive his transgression, there are one or two rules that all fair-room fools must observe if they love their profession. There are one or two rules, half a dozen maybe, that all family fools of every degree must observe if they love their profession. If you wish to succeed as a jester, you need to consider each person's auricula. What is all right for B would quite scandalize C, for C is so very particular. And D may be dull, and E's very thick skull is as empty of brains as a ladle. While F is F sharp, and will cry with a carp that he's known your best joke from his cradle. When you humor they flout, you can't let yourself go, and it does put you out, and a person says, oh, I have known that old joke from my cradle. If your master is surly from getting up early and tempers are short in the morning, an inopportune joke is enough to provoke him to give you at once a month's warning. Then if you refrain, he is at you again, for he likes to get value for money. He'll ask then and there with an insolent stare if you know that you're paid to be funny. It adds to the task of a merriman's place when your principal asks with a scowl on his face if you know that you're paid to be funny. Comes a bishop, maybe you're a solemn DD, oh beware of his anger provoking. Better not pull his hair, don't stick pins in his chair, he don't understand practical joking. If the jest that you crack have an orthodox smack, you may get a bland smile from these sages. But should it by chance be imported from France, half a crown is stopped out of your wages. It's a general rule, or your zeal it may quench, if the family fool tells a joke that's too French, half a crown is stopped out of his wages. Though your head it may rack with a bilious attack, and your senses with toothache you're losing, don't be mopey and flat, they don't fine you from that if you're properly quaint and amusing. Though your wife ran away with a soldier that day and took with her your trifle of money, bless your heart, they don't mind, they're exceedingly kind, they don't blame you as long as you're funny. It's a comfort to feel though your partner should fit, though you suffer a deal, they don't mind it a bit. They don't blame you so long as you're funny.
Pocket bull, 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 pocket bull
As hell till his last hour, gyves that no smith can weld, no rust devour. Although a monarch's hand had set him free, of all the captive band, the saddest soul.
so.
Why, an arquebus fired from the wharf, unless I much mistake.
Strange, and at such an hour, what can it mean?
Like a ghost in vigil keeping,
or a spectre all appalling,
I beheld a figure creeping.
I should rather call it crawling.
He was creeping, he was crawling,
he was creeping, creeping,
crawling.
He was creeping, he was crawling,
he was creeping, creeping,
crawling.
Not a moment's hesitation, I myself upon him flung, with a hurried exclamation to his draperies I hung. Then we closed with one another in our rough and tumble smother. Colonel Fairfax and no other was the man to whom I clung.
Mighty tug and tuss,
it resembled more a struggle,
be by dint of stronger muscle,
or by some infernal juggle,
from my clutches quickly sliding.
I should rather call it slipping,
with the view no doubt of hiding,
or escaping to the shipping.
With a gasp and with a quiver,
I describe it as a shiver.
Down he dived into the river, and alas, I cannot swim.
Ingenuity is catching with the view my king of pleasing after he bust from sent to snatching.
I should rather call it seizing.
With an ounce or two of lead, I dispatch him through the head. I discharge it without winking. Little time I lost in thinking. Like a stone I saw him sinking.
I should say a lump of lead.
Like a stone I saw him sinking.
I should say a lump of lead.
Like a stone, my boy, I say.
Like a heavy lump of lead.
Like a stone, my boy, I say.
Like a heavy lump of lead.
Anyhow the man is dead. With a stone, a lump of lead.
Anyhow the man is dead. With a stone, a lump of lead.
Himself to the trade and study all day in methodical way how to flatter, cajole and persuade. He should prentice himself at 14 and practice from morning to e'en. And when he's of age, if he will, I'll engage he may capture the heart of a queen, the heart of a queen.
It is purely a matter of skill, which all may attain if they will. But every jack he must study the neck if he wants to make sure of his jill. If he wants to make sure of his jill.
If he's made the best use of his time, his twig is a carefully lined.
matter of skill, which all may attain if they will. But every Jack he must study the knack if he wants to make sure of his jill. He wants to make sure of his jill.
Thank you. speak joy and jollity, then is polity, pain, frivolity, rapture, rapture, joy and jollity, then is polity, pain, frivolity, rapture, rapture.
Doleful, doleful, when humanity, with its soul full of satanity, courting privity, down declivity, seeks captivity, doleful, doleful, courting privity, down declivity, seeks captivity, doleful, doleful.
Joyful, joyful, when virginity seeks all coyful man's affinity, pate of glory, bright and glory, is adoring, joyful, joyful, pate of glory, bright and glory, is adoring, joyful, joyful.
Ghastly, ghastly, when man sorrowful, firstly, lastly, of tomorrowful, after tarrying, yields to harry, goes a-marrying, ghastly, ghastly.
Joyful, joyful,
ghastly, ghastly,
joyful, joyful,
ghastly, 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 ghastly. Doleful, doleful, when humanity with its soul full of satanity, caught in divinity, down declivity, seeks captivity, doleful, caught in divinity, down declivity, seeks captivity. Doleful, 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 doleful,
husband lives.
thought of learned metal set aside. Thou art mine own, I claim thee as my bride.
Thou art his own, alas, he claims thee as his bride.
A suppliant at thy feet I fall, mine heart will yield to pity's call.
Mine is a heart of massive rock, unmoved by sentimental shock,
my husband and me.
My loved one come to me, they bear me somewhere. What will they take me far from me?
As he sighed for the love.